Welcome to Ginger Cook Monday with Ginger Crumb and Ginger Cook at the helm. Ginger Sammy. What's the story there, boy?
Sammy's long.
He's been working too hard at the beach. Too hard at the beach.
That's right.
Yeah, let's see if we can find Ginger. Yeah, there you are.
Hi, you guys. So welcome to Ginger Cook Live, our Monday night. This is a Cookie Crumb lesson. Somehow Ginger Crumb sounds kind of crummy, you know what I mean? Like, I'm not sure I like that. Ginger Crumb, crummy ginger. I don't know.
Well, maybe we should change it. Ginger Crumbs. Let's try. They're really Cookie Crumbs.
Yeah.
But are they really crumbs anymore? I mean, this was originally, folks, a 15-minute snippet.
That's right.
And we have got that 15 minutes in the next hour and a half.
Yeah. But if you just stumbled in here, you saw a live show, wonder what that was about, you've never watched this before, what happens is we're going to do something on the show. We're going to play some games. We're going to watch a painting being created. We're going to leave it up on YouTube so you can come back and create it. You can chat with your friends. If you have questions for me, you want to put those in cap letters, that's not guaranteed. We'll see it. We have some wonderful moderators because a lot of chat. Sometimes people get going and then they start talking about their dog, Susie, or something, and then off they go in that direction. And it's hard to catch the thread sometimes. You have to understand, you got to read fast. And so we do our best we can. Sometimes our moderators will tell us. And speaking of moderators, we want to give a shout out to Wendy and to
Samsung.
Simran, right? I called her Samsung.
Simran? Now who's Simran? Kim Sim. Poor Kim. Kim, I apologize. There's nothing I could do. I'm sorry. There's just no hope for today already. The bear, you still have the bear snoozing.
I mean, it's been one of those kind of days. I mean, you gotta, you know, you wake up to water all over the floor in the laundry room because the washing machine has failed. I'm just telling you, after that, everything's funny. You know what I mean?
It just goes downhill from there.
It's just funny, you know. Well, sort of funny, tragic. So anyway, yeah, so what we're going to do is we're going to be doing that stuff. And
What was the stuff that we were doing?
We're painting.
Okay.
We're painting.
Hey, what are we going to
paint
today?
Painting this nifty, I'll just hold it up for you. This nifty now. Awesome.
Whoa.
Meringue pie.
Lemon meringue.
Lemon meringue pie, you know, which I don't even like, but we're going to paint that. You know, I don't even eat that. Don't send me it. I don't eat those things, right? But I like the idea of it. It's all very fluffy and pretty, and I thought this would be fun to paint. And we're going to be painting that. It's kind of a fun kitchen painting to have, you know. And I'm going to show you some other paintings we have that go with them that are over on our website. Also, we're going to, well, we will not, and our game is over as far as the secret word game.
The 8 secret word game has been concluded.
There will be no secret words this video. Though we have some funny ideas. I'm going to throw out a question for you now in our trivia, because we were thinking about this isn't part of the game. Does anybody know?
This is just something fun.
This is fun.
Humor
us. Does anybody know? Just see if you can chat. We'll just, we won't shout out the answers for a minute, but John will keep note the answers. Well, guess who's the first person? That's it. Who's the first person that can tell us, right?
Now, listen closely. Listen very, very closely.
What was the nickname of Vincent Van Gogh's favorite drink, and what was the drink? Okay, all right. I'll be putting out my paint. John's going to scoot the camera down here to the table.
I'm going to scoot the camera down.
Yeah, so you can show. This is what we're painting. I'll be putting out some paint while you're thinking about that. I want to thank everybody who participated. We had over 200 people send in entries for our 8 secret words, but we had about 160 correct ones. We will be doing a drawing tomorrow night on the live tomorrow night to see who wins the free painting. Our auction is closed for all our paintings that we were selling, and we will be sending the high bidders
an invoice and a thank you.
And as soon as you know, and we'll try to get your paintings out to you ASAP. They're all ready to go with their certificate of authenticity and all that stuff, just ready to find out who you are and get your payment and get them mailed back to you.
And we'd like to thank everybody for that first round. It was very, very successful. We're happy with the results. And it seems like you guys have an interest in this, so we are going to get some official-type software. It's going to be more an eBay-type auction where it's not going to be manual. The first one we did manually, not knowing.
So today for my mixing white, I'm using Liquitex mixing white. We've been playing around with that. John, when we did the live show yesterday, we used mixing white from Winsor Newton Infinity, and this is really old, so
it's gummy.
It was kind of gunky, you know, so it's
gummy.
Old. It's not their
gunky.
Fault, I don't gummy. Think. It's just, you know, sometimes things just, we're trying to use up stuff, you know what I'm saying? So,
oh,
you know,
ginger.
What I don't have, John, is any burnt umber.
You had it earlier.
No, but I used the last of it up.
Great.
So, do you happen to have some in your kit? I'm sorry, I didn't see it till
you
now.
No, we need to negotiate this. This was my kit.
Well, we'll replace it. We'll put it back in your kit, you know?
I don't know about the lesson this week.
Oh, the lesson this week. Here's what happened, you guys. We had a lot
There's
going
a
on. Between the no air conditioning and the contests and all the paintings, and John didn't finish editing because it was a big deal lesson. It was one that was shot with a bunch of cameras, and it took a lot longer. And he's got day one finished?
Day one is about done.
Yes, and day one is about done. He intends to put that up. And we're sorry, we just didn't get that up in as soon and up in time, but we'll show you the picture. That's that beautiful barn with all the flowers and everything. And that is going up. I give up. Where is it? He says, you know, it's so funny. You know where it is. Just like, you know, like, yeah. But anyway, that's the one we're doing. Putting a little burnt sienna, a little ultramarine blue, a little phthalo blue today. So that was that, and then the other painting that's going to be going up for this week is going to be the cherries with the tangerine. So,
oh, great, that's another long lesson.
Well, I don't know, maybe it won't be. Maybe I lied. It seemed like it was a good idea at the time, so sorry, right? Here's some burnt umber.
So you wanted the barn picture.
Yeah, that. Well, we had it, didn't we have it soon? We had it to show somebody. You know, we do a lot of this show and tell stuff. Let's see, we want some yellow oxide. We're going to put some of that out. We're going to paint this today. Yellow oxide, coarse cad yellow medium, which I also need. How is this possible? I have cad yellow light, but I don't have cad yellow medium.
I think I have that in my kit, too.
Oh, isn't that great? Because I don't have it. And I'm going to try a little Australian sienna. If you don't have it, don't worry about it. If you had it, that would be super good. Incidentally, those of you who have been sending me stuff on Facebook, I've been very impressed with some of the paintings that have come through. And, of course, this is The Promise, is the painting that we'll be giving away tomorrow night on the show for those of you that entered. There was, like I say, over 160 correct entries. And how we're going to do it is that we're going to put all the names in, like, a bowl or a hat or something, and we're going to draw one out, and that's who wins, okay? So you can watch that tomorrow night. Here's this week's... Cad yellow medium. Yeah, that's what I want. Thank you.
Yeah.
No, I already have the light. I want cad yellow medium. And this is the barn picture. This is our weekly release for GingerCookLive.gallery. It should have been up last Saturday. We just didn't get it up. We had, you know, some issues in the house. It was a time. We had the air conditioning guy came on Saturday. For those who like the continuous soap opera of the life of Ginger Cook, we got this. My ex found him down in Galveston, sweet man, very nice, about 67 years old, really sweet, and had been on a really amazing diet, had lost over 70 pounds, and he was still topping. He's told us about 380 pounds, I think he still weighed. And we've got this little wooden ladder that goes up into the attic that's really old, and I mean, I can barely get up it, and I think there was a little, I don't know, was that a screwdriver or something? It was kind of holding one of the things in place, something. Anyway, he was going up the ladder with his 50-pound bag of tools, and he did that about three times. And the third time coming down the ladder, we heard this yell. I mean, just how, you know, we're downstairs, we heard this yell, help, help. And of course, he had collapsed the ladder. He's okay. He was okay. Fortunately, he got the air conditioning fixed. I'm sorry, that sounds very selfish, before he collapsed it. I don't know how. We've got to fix the ladder now. So anyway, that was that's what happened there. And let's see. Do I have another? Yeah, some phthalo blue here.
You better need no more colors. I'm sitting down now.
You're sitting down.
You can get that bear up next. get him, go get him.
Yeah, let the bear go get him. All right, so these are the last of our colors. So, but I'm happy to say that the air conditioning seems to be working right now. And since the units were put in 1990, we just, every summer, we just kind of go, oh, please, another year, let the air conditioner work another year. You know?
Another summer,
let's get through another summer. And in Houston, summer start early. I mean, this is just April, okay? And it's not even begun to get hot. So for something like this, I'm not going to show you the actual photograph, but you know there was a photograph involved here of the meringue. But you have my picture, so you're going to have to go with that. And normally I would paint the whole canvas, but I'm not going to do that because of this blue color. All right. So what I want to do is I just have a photo of my picture like that. Let me just move this out of the way. I'm going to show you how I'm going to do this. Here's just a photocopy of my picture. And we won't have this up tonight on the website, but we will have it up under resources. John still thinks resources is a great name. Guess what?
Resources is a fantastic name. Let's not go over that. Let's address the one issue that came up over the weekend that I would like to thank everybody that showed support for me being on the show, because Ginger was ready to fire me.
I was not. I was never going to fire John. I made that perfectly clear,
yeah,
John. No one was firing you.
Right? We really appreciate the support. You guys are fantastic.
Yeah, thank you very much. It really touched John. It's funny, you know, I get a few of those. Every once in a while somebody writes that. It wasn't like the first comment I'd heard, but for some reason that particular comment was very upsetting to me. And, you know, and I wrote that sort of, you know, just saying that, you know, I just didn't think most people felt that way. And so we really appreciate that. Thank you very much. Made John feel much better, too. You know, he and I have a really good time together, and we have a great relationship. And some people, I don't know, probably maybe from where you're sitting. Have you ever gotten a text message? You have friends that text message you, and you never know if you're being insulted or not?
Just because of their choice of words.
Because of the way they write it. I mean, yeah. My ex-boss, Jeff, you know, I'll say his name. I used to hate getting any text message. I couldn't tell the tone of his text message. I know that sounds kind of funny. I'm a person that likes to hear voices. I do better with voices than with just words. Text messages can be very disconcerting.
Well, you don't know what you don't know the tone behind it.
Well, no, you don't. And you know, and you never know if he was kidding. I never knew. And then I'd say, "Well, are you upset?" And he'd go, "No." And I'd go, "Seemed upset to me." Right, and so I used to dread getting anything from him. So this is a little 8x10 canvas. We've sanded it.
Listen to that. Listen to that drum. I tightened that one up for her.
See, do you hear the drum on that? That's what it is. That's you spray water on the back. Hear the drum. Now we're just using what we call. This is a transfer wax-free transfer paper. It's by Sorel. There's a link on our website to this under what? How would you find this? If you went to our website and wanted the link to find this?
You wouldn't.
Well, there you go, no?
Okay, let's think. When would I have done this? Let's see. I'm 3 videos behind. I have a bear that's now sleeping all the time and playing in the pool. You're painting all the time, giving more things to edit. The website had an upgrade I had to fix.
Oh, yeah. Okay. So where would they find this, John?
Go to Amazon. Go to our website, though, if you would. We would appreciate it.
Go through our website to get to Amazon.
And just click one of the Amazon links. You know, we're an affiliate of Amazon, and every little penny helps us.
So Sorel, it's called Sorel Transfer Paper. And the reason I like it, just comes with 5 colors. And you can use this stuff over and over again. I've never shown you the blue, so we're going to show you the blue now. And let's just do a quick test. I see the wax, you know, the darker color side goes down.
That's easy to tell on that one versus
the white.
The
white's a little more tricky, but it feels a little differently. See, did that transfer? See there? See the blue? Yeah, it works. So what you do so that things don't move around is you start taping stuff down a little bit. But you can use this stuff over and over again. Sorel also sells it in, like, wax paper kind of carton things.
Rolls over.
Incidentally, I had this student one time. I'm sorry, I digress, but I get sidetracked easily. I had this student one time, and you know, it was a guy thing, right? And he needed a brush holder, and he was taking classes from me down at Jerry's, and he came in with a recycled aluminum foil box with a rubber band, and it fit perfectly all his brushes in there. It had a little paper towel to kind of soak up the moisture. And then he put the brushes in it to carry him. And
so
then
what did he have? What was it?
A recycled aluminum foil box, you know, where the rolls go in there.
He just put his brushes in there.
He just put his brushes in there and put a paper towel in there to soak up any moisture when he carried them home, because you have to keep your wet brushes flat. Don't you think that's clever? And I thought, you know, a little care. He could have taken some cute wrapping paper, you know, maybe covered it, made it cuter. You could have been done.
Okay, this is a guy. We don't care. Functionality.
I know, but I'm just saying it could have been cuter. And then you could have, instead of that ugly rubber band, you kind of had a little double stick Velcro, something like that. And then you would have had a very wonderful, very green recycled brush container. So maybe one of the craft girls on YouTube will make one and show people how to do it.
Can we see Ginger's pin she is wearing?
The pin? This pin? Yeah,
here. Yeah, there it is. See? There it is.
My pin.
Look closely. I can't zoom that camera.
It says Ginger Cook, and it's a paint palette.
It's cute.
I found it in the jewelry drawer the other day, and I'm thinking, oh, yeah, I should put that on. That's a good idea. It's got the wrong website on it now. It's so old. But
Well, nobody can read it.
Well, anyway, it's just John saw it, and he said, where'd you get that? He's been here, 6 months, never saw it. So
yeah.
I said, oh, I've had that. He says, well, you should wear that on the show. I said, yeah, I could. Okay, so I'm trying to tape this on, right, like that, okay? And I'm taping it on here like this, so my picture on, so it doesn't move around. It doesn't do any good. The reason you tape things is you don't want your picture to move about. One could see where that wouldn't be helpful, right? So I've taped it down. Then you take a pin. It's just not moving anywhere. Let's just test right here like that, right? That seems to work. Then you take a pin. You want a pin. And I got to put my glasses on so I can kind of see where I've been. And if you use it again, if you were to draw over this again, now I freehanded this out, and I'm going to show you basically how you draw this in on the chalkboard. Okay, I'm just going to pen this in for now, and while we're waiting for something to dry, I'll show you how it's very easy. I freehanded this in earlier today. I just, you know, I mean, we don't want a 3-hour show here, friends. So I'm just going to do it this way. But I will show you basically how you draw it in.
We go to 2 hours already. We have a question from Jewel Song. My mixing white hasn't arrived yet. Can it be approximated with titanium white and gel?
No.
How about water and white?
No.
Can I make mixing white in any way?
No.
Well, you can if you have zinc white, right?
You can't make zinc white because mixing white is half zinc, half titanium, so you really can't make it. So, you know, it's okay. Just eventually it'll come. That's a little innate, but that's about the best I can tell you. Eventually it should show up for you, but you really can't.
And we're in fine shape on that too. We're about out.
Yeah, we're out too. I appreciate it. And I've decided, you know, I really like the golden. I like the Liquitex mixing white, and I like the golden zinc white pretty much in the tubes. I'm just not a big fan of things in the jars because even though it seems like it'd be too easy to contaminate white, I've got a bunch of white in jars and
we
other colors in jars.
White.
But I have to tell you, I'm not a big fan of this. You know, just that's me personally. So here's the outer rim of this plate like this. Okay, and let's see, how did I do with the drawing on here? I think I'm pretty good here. You know, I've got I just need the outside shape. I don't need a lot in here. I'm just kind of trying to make this a little easier on myself. But this is probably fine. Let's see. Oh, what's up here? Yeah, maybe. Yeah, this is fine. Okay, we got enough on here. We're fine. Here's the sorrel paper. Here, see how that got on the... See how that's on the canvas now? Which is fine, right?
Lady Blush 5, Ginger, why do you spray the back of your canvas with water?
Because it tightens it up.
Makes it sound like a drum.
It makes it tight as a drum, and they come too loose, and that's why you spray it, and that's why you want this sound. Hear it?
There you go.
There you go. You want that sound. And that's why you spray it. Hot water really works. Okay, so we're back to our picture. Here's what we're painting in case you came in here late. If you guys are new, we really appreciate it if you would subscribe to our channel. And you know, share these videos and help tell others about us. We appreciate it. These are some fun food. I thought this would be really fun, nice kitchen decor. It's an 8x10 canvas. It's going to be pretty simple to use. And this is pretty easy to do. I'll move this out of the way. I'm using some ruby satin silver brushes here today. Here we go. It's just something like that. You can kind of see where I am. This is what we're painting. Now, the reason I picked these colors, originally this was a white plate on a brown background. Okay? That was the photo. And I can't show you the photo, but I can show you this. Now, the blue plate. But I went ahead and I chose those colors because on your color wheel, turquoise is opposite orange. On the color wheel, and orange and turquoise are complements. And when you put those together in a painting, they're really pretty. You know, there's a reason why I picked that background. I mean, you could pick black, you could pick anything, but the orange really, really goes. You could have picked, made a purple plate, baby, and picked a yellow background. I mean, just, you know, you got to think about those things. Red and green, purple and yellow, turquoise and orange, all right? So now let's start with, I didn't quite finish drawing that in, so I'll finish it here like this. I've got a little bit of a crust that's coming this way, out like this from the plate like that, but that's all right. I can see where that line goes. Now, while I'm gonna start, okay, with just painting the inside of my plate. So I'm gonna take some white and a little tiny bit of phthalo blue, like that. The tiny bit of yellow oxide to it, okay? Tiny bit of yellow oxide and a little more white, okay, like that. A little more yellow oxide, there you go. And I've got this sort of turquoise color, can you see that? And I'm just gonna come in here like this around where I know my pie's gonna be. And I'll just give this the first coat of color. That's all I'm doing right now is the first coat of color. Anybody figure out the answer to our question? Did anybody?
Yeah, no, I haven't seen any of those answers come by.
Okay, so what was the answer? The question was, what was Van Gogh's nickname for his favorite drink, and what was his favorite drink? That's the question. Anybody come up with that yet?
I'm scrolling back up, and I'm not seeing that.
Okay, so maybe some new people showing up. That's our sort of trivia question of the hour. We'll play some more trivia games. All right, so I will give you some hints on the nickname. All right.
No, really?
Yeah. Was it the Green Hornet? Was it the Green Submarine? Was it the Green Fairy?
Roll up.
Anybody?
Yeah, now they're coming in.
Now they're thinking.
Yeah. We have everybody saying Green Fairy and the
Absence. Yeah. Absence. That was the call. Don't you love that Green Fairy? Isn't that a cute nickname for a drink, Green Fairy? I think that was adorable. I mean, just trying to think about way back then. I guess you don't think.
You know, they probably answered this question when I was running around getting all your paintings, and all that's off the feed now.
Off the feed now. Oh, yeah. See, I bet that's what
happened. I apologize that Ginger made me run around getting pictures.
Yeah, that's right. You should feel real bad about that.
I do.
I'm going to
wake up the bear and have him take over.
Okay, so I'm going to just come in here with a little bit more white to kind of next to my pie here. I'm just going to, this is my first layer. Now, when you're painting everything, it's not like a coloring book. So you've got to figure you've got some layers here. So you've got to get something down. So we're just getting down some basic colors. You see that? We're not getting too clever. And all I'm doing here, maybe in the clever department, is that if I didn't quite have that plate rounded, I will do it. So now I said I'd show you how you might draw this. And let me just take a squirter bottle and clean off the chalkboard, which should have been clean, but we got busy today. Did anybody happen to catch John's great adventure Sunday? Did you guys see that, where John started painting clouds? That was what we did on Sunday, and he did so well. Didn't you guys think so? And that of course is up. That's episode
four.
And just as a note, somebody, you know, said, you know, you guys really ought to turn the hairdryer off. It's so obnoxious. And listen, we turn it down when we're doing it here, but we can't turn it off there. It's 10 feet away, the controls for the hairdryer. John's sitting right next to me. We just turn the camera on, run over here and sit down, hope for the best, right? We can't do any of that stuff, you know? So we always suggest that, you know, if that's not fun, then just mute the sound or something, you know? All right, so.
Or change the channel.
Change the channel, mute the sound, do something, you know? All right, so I'm gonna just show you briefly what I'm talking about. When you're tackling something like this, remember, an oval is a circle that fits in a rectangle. So what you need to do when you're trying to draw an oval is think about, you know, I don't quite have it here, but think about your rectangle. Think about in cutting off the corners like this, right? There's your oval. Now, in this case, it was down a little bit lower than up at the top, but there's your oval, all right? So if you'll notice that this pie, all right, and then there's an inside, obviously there's an inside rim to this plate, but your pie is straight across here like this, and then it comes up at an angle like that, comes across, okay, like this, and basically it's got a little crust like this, and then it's got some meringue that's coming this way and coming up like this. Here's your meringue top, and then here it's coming like this on your pie and goes up something like that. Does that make sense? But that's the shape of this, all right? So this wasn't particularly that hard to draw. It comes up a little bit higher than the plate here, comes up here like this. This is the meringue, and then this is the yellow stuff. What is that? Lemon meringue pie. Here's the crust, and then the rest is your plate, and then here's your picture. So that's basically how you draw it. But again, we'll have it traceable for you at some point. Not tonight, but some point, okay? And I will put this up on Pinterest, this picture up on the Pinterest board, and you're more than welcome to come over to my Pinterest board, Ginger Cook Live, all one word, and just print it out too, by the way, okay? So people always ask us about that. And people say, why don't you put out the colors you use? We use the same colors all the time. We don't change. Same colors all the time, pretty much. That's it. All right, so...
And you can always look at the first beginning of the painting, because yeah, the palette has all of them listed right there.
Yeah, on all the questions on all the colors. So, needless to say... We've got that going. Now I'm going to rinse my brush here, because I've got... and I think I'll come up here with a little bit of... let's take a little bit of burnt sienna, a little bit of yellow, okay? Burnt sienna, a little bit of yellow, and come on up here, and I'm just going to paint in this little pie crust here. You want the edge to be kind of lumpy. Does that make sense? It's very lumpy and uneven, okay? There's our little bit of pie crust, right, like that.
And remember not to clone.
Yeah, not to clone. Yes, that's it. Okay, so
that's
now...
That's all I learned over the weekend.
That's what, not
cloning.
To clone. So now we're going to take that same color, a little bit of yellow, a little bit of burnt sienna, okay? And we're going to come in here like this, and give it the part of our still dark streaks in here, a little bit darker, okay, in here like this, like that, maybe come down here at the bottom, make this darker, have a few little dark streaks in our pie crust. Nothing too new, nothing too drastic. There we go. See, that's pretty easy. I mean, really, honestly, a little bit darker up here. Now you notice, you hear the little sound of the water rinsing the brush. Now, yellow only paints over white, so I'm going to take a little titanium white, a little bit of yellow, okay? And I'm going to come up here and say that here is the top of my lemon meringue, like that, up here, like this. There's the top of that, and there's a little bit of that under here, like this, which we will shade in a minute, but that's this part right here. And then I'm going to take a tiny bit of Cad Red Medium in yellow, okay? And I want to come along here like that, a little more yellow, and kind of give it a little bit of color on this side, and then more orange. I'm still going to be into the orange now, so we're just playing with that, a little bit more orange color. Cad Red Medium is kind of an orange color, and I'm going to say that the tip of this, a little more red, is the tip of the pie's got a little orange in it. It's a little bit of an orange over here. Maybe a little tiny bit of light orange on this pie crust right here, not much, just touch. Maybe over here, just a few places. All right. Now, then what else could I do? Well, I'm going to come up here with Cad Red Medium in yellow now. There's no white in it. I'm going to mix it. So I know the rest of my canvas is orange. So we can be painting that in and chatting. And while we're doing that, let's have another trivia question.
Oh, a real one?
A two. Number two, John.
A number two.
Okay,
number
that's
two.
From our
this
game.
Our...
I thought my question that was really cool about...
It was a great question.
About Vincent Van Gogh.
That's one we made up ourselves.
Yeah, we were going to have something called Stump the Audience, you know? That was my big plan.
We're trying to figure out how that's going to work.
We haven't figured it out, that you guys could mail in your own questions and, you know, with proof, and we'd figure it out. But if we ever figure that out, we'll let you guys play. We thought that would be fun, too. Stump the Audience, you know? But... Anyway, at this point, what's your question, John? What do you got?
Oh, I got to find something I can read, that's for sure.
You don't have your glasses?
Well, I don't have the glasses I can use here.
All right, nice.
Okay, what is the name for clothing folds on a sculpture or in a painting? Draping, festoon, or smock?
For painting or making folds?
For what is the name for clothing? clothing folds.
Cloaking folds?
Clothing.
Clothing folds. Oh, for clothing folds.
Clothing folds.
In a painting?
On a sculpture or in a painting.
Okay, and the choices are?
Draping, festoon, F-E-S-T-O-O-N, and smock, S-M-O-C-K.
Okay. Well, that's an interesting thing. Well,
your competition tonight is April, is about to give birth, and everybody's going to bail on you if she gives birth during your show. Just to let you know, if all of a sudden we have nobody left, it's because April's giving birth.
That's gosh, April. Oh, congratulations. But she's not watching, is she?
April's the giraffe, honey.
What?
The giraffe, April.
Oh, that April. Okay.
I'm so glad you stay up on the news and what's going on in the world. The rest of the year. Okay. We have a draping,
well,
a festoon.
Did, you know, there's 200 draping, people out there. Draping, who draping, knew, draping, right?
A smock. I don't see a baby yet. Festoon, babe. Wow, who won the painting? Painting winner will be announced tomorrow night.
Tomorrow night we'll do a live drawing. You
live.
Just watch it.
Live
night.
And in
live
person. Woo-hoo.
I'm going to put all the names in a hat. There were 160 correct entries.
We didn't count spelling errors
either, by
the
way.
Yeah, spelling errors didn't count.
You didn't count. If you got it,
I can't spell. I can barely speak. How am I going to do that to you guys?
We didn't count spelling errors. Now, I'm putting a little more Cad Red Medium in the corners like this. Make it a little darker in the corners. You see
all
that?
All right. The answer is Ginger.
Yes.
No.
Oh, I know what it is. Yes, it's the draping thing. Draper.
It's a draping thing. Yeah. Indeed it is. It is a draping thing.
Yeah, I would think that would be the answer. Yes?
Yes, that is the answer.
Yay, I got it. Ginger got it. Yay.
And so did 95% of the audience.
Okay, give us
of our studio
harder.
Audience. Would you like
the studio audience like that? All right, let's just do something better. Come on. What do you got?
Four. What do I got? That's a where.
I'm not very good at the where question.
Well, you shouldn't have rolled a four then.
Well, I guess not, huh? Because I shouldn't have rolled a four. Okay. Well.
As long as I don't have to say the names, I'll see if anybody can just answer the question.
Uh-huh.
Where can you visit the home of Vincent van Gogh? Do you know what it is?
Yeah.
Okay. Don't say it.
Well, why would I say it? I'm going to get a little dazzling purple. Did I put any out? I didn't.
Can the background be done before the
I
plate?
I forgot to
before
put the dazzling purple out. Okay.
Brenda wants to know, can the background be done before the pie in the plate?
Well, the problem is it can, but then it takes a lot of paint to paint over it. But you could, I think. I think you could. I just did it. You know, you could. You could, absolutely. It's going to take a little more paint to paint over it. So that's why I didn't do it that way. When I did the original, I just drew chalk right on the canvas. Now I'm taking a little purple into that. Notice this. This is purple into the orange. And see how it turns brown? Into the wet orange. And then I'm melting this out because I want a shadow under this plate. Okay, like that. I'm coming along. If this was 6 o'clock, this is 12 o'clock.
I believe they're asking for an actual city.
Not a country?
Not a country. It's an actual city.
Oh, a city.
Yeah. What country are you talking?
Holland.
You're talking Holland. Really?
I'm talking Holland.
That probably is that. I mean, it's a word I can't.
Well, he was born in Holland. His parents lived there. So, I mean,
The question again is, where can you visit the home of Vincent van Gogh, the actual town? I'm assuming that's a town.
I will
tell you right now, it's three hyphenated words, and they're not English.
Okay, so, obviously it's not New York. So, let's move, you know, we know that. You know, we've eliminated Moscow and New York, right? And Houston, so
yeah, Houston,
you know, he's
here, out.
So I hate to disappoint you. Taking a little purple, I'm going to outline of this crust a little bit here.
S. Curtis would like to know, can I make my entire background orange and then paint my blue plate on top
of
it?
Wait, I just answered that.
No. You asked, do I have to do the background first around?
Well, I mean, you could. When you paint over orange, blue over orange, just tell me, do some orange and dry it, and then paint some turquoise over it and see what happens. Because you'll probably have to paint your paint plate white and then put the turquoise over it. So this was just easy.
It's very similar to what you have to do when you do the yellow.
Yeah. So, but you could. You're absolutely right. You could. You know, this is acrylics. You can do anything.
Yeah.
You know, so I'm going to just bring this
over yonder.
A little bit.
I like that answer.
What's that?
Over yonder.
Over yonder, yeah. Just, yeah, over yonder. Well, I think it's somewhere in Holland, but though he died in France. I think he was renting.
Oh, renter, huh?
He was renting. He didn't own anything in France. He was renting. And unless you're talking about the, you know, he was renting.
Sue Clark has the answer.
She does?
Yep.
Good for you, Sue. Did she Google it?
She had to Google it.
Did she know it or did
Sue,
she Google it?
Sue, did you know that answer? Did you
just
Google it?
Just honestly, let's tell you. Did
oh,
she
that's
Google
in
it?
France. It's in France.
It was in France. I didn't
think. Meringue is saying it's in France.
Well, maybe it is in France, and maybe, but I don't think he actually owned it.
Well, I just said, where can you visit the home of?
Well, maybe that's the last place he rented.
You know. Yeah, Sue, can you pronounce it for us?
See, here's a little bit of the dark here on there, right? You see that? Now, I've got a little of this purple on my brush, a little bit of phthalo blue, okay?
I gotta say, that was a hard
one. Now I'm gonna go back to white, and I'm gonna make a sort of shadow color, like that, with a little purple, and a little tiny burnt sienna. Rather burnt umber, sorry, a little burnt umber. So here's my little darker shadow color, all right? Now, I'm going to come under this part on the plate right here, this little inside section right here, and I'm going to come to about 6 o'clock. Think of this as a clock. This is 6, this is 12, 9, 3, okay? So when I'm referring to that, that's where I'm going with that little shadow.
That's a commune in France, northwestern suburb of Paris.
Okay.
So if somebody said Paris, we'd have to give it to you.
Okay, well, that's good. I mean, I didn't know that, so now I'm adding a little white to that. Kind of changing the background colors of this plate a little bit. Now, adding a little bit of white.
That was a tough one.
And it was tough, you know, and just get a little more of the phthalo color coming in here. That's with the little yellow. Okay, so here we go. So we darken this up in here just a hair. And I want to put a little bit of a shadow right here on this end of the pie plate here like this. Right here, there's a little shadow right here like that, kind of straight across here, down here like that. The pie was right there.
Pie's
then I'm
going to
get a little bit more white and put it in here like that. Wipe the brush off. You'll see me wipe the brush all the time. See me painting this. Just sort of pushing this in here now, just sort of tapping it in. Okay. Like that. And then I want a little ultramarine blue. Now this is our other shadow color. I can say it's an ultramarine blue here on the pie right here like this. I'm going to come under here like this with a little ultramarine blue. It's a shadow right under the actual pie. And then maybe a little bit going this way. Just a tiny bit going on this ridge.
Oh, Nancy's okay. Coming in late. It was his resting place. His final resting place was there.
Okay. All right, so now we're going to go ahead.
This canvas is an 8x10.
8x10, and we're going to get a little phthalo blue, a little cat yellow oxide, a little white. And this is our next layer of color that's coming along here. This is layer two.
Ooh, I have a question.
Yeah?
John, what are you hoping to be able to paint, and what do you have a painting goal?
He wants to paint tractors. Let's ask him.
Tractors and barns.
Tractors and barns, right?
I don't know yet. I got to get this material to work the way I want it to work. Not the way Ginger gets it to work. I can't get it to work yet. Hey, I'm only on number 5.
He's only on number 5. But listen, for our members only, we have a surprise for you guys. Now, those of you who got to see John's painting Sunday, this is the painting he did last Sunday's of clouds. He'd never painted clouds before. This was the first clouds he started. Look how good he got down by the second clouds, okay?
By the end.
We concluded our live Raz Reality Art Studio show with John, episode 4. That was Sunday. That's on YouTube. But then I thought that he really needed to keep painting. So what we did was we went ahead and filmed it, but it'll be released later for, if you're a member of Ginger Cook Live, one of our members, you're going to see him paint this. And that was his last set of, are you impressed? He actually did that in the next hour from what he learned here. And we have that as a video, and that will be released
sometime,
and I'm not even sure if we shouldn't release it this week, John, for this week's lesson.
Well, we may because
of editing. And we may release that this week for this week's lesson after the barn. We may release this so you guys can follow along and see how John did this. And this was, then again, we did this for our members, gingercooklive.gallery. So I thought that was kind of cute. Now, if you want to see, this was his first painting, all right? There was his second painting. Here's his third. So this is a guy that's never painted before, and you're getting the whole journey on YouTube too. You're following along, and you're every brushstroke, because I sit right next to him like a private lesson. Private lessons run, you know, very pricey here in Houston to get one from me. John gets a, you guys get a private lesson with me and John on these, you know, just we give them to you. I think it's kind of cool. And then again, and then we did this last one, and look at the improvement. Look how much better he's getting each week. So you can whine all you want to about it. It's not quite working. I think it's working very well for you myself, but that could just be me, right? But what do I
not
know?
What I want yet.
All right, I'm going to take a little mixing white now, and I'm going to come along on my
plate. I'm
going
to be able to do my tractor and barn with chickens running around.
All right, so here's a little mixing white here, and I'm going to lighten up the plate like that. Do you see that? Now, if you didn't have this color, you could just use a little white and add it to your light blue and just mix that color. This, see how beautifully this lightens up the plate? And it just even here, I want to lighten up the shadow a bit. There it is. Kind of softens the shadow. And I have to bring a little pie crust over. I didn't quite go far enough with the pie crust. So a little, if you don't have, that was a little Southern Ocean blue. If you don't have that, or rather Australian Sienna, if you don't have that, don't worry about it. You can use yellow oxide and burnt sienna and get something pretty close. So here I'm going to bring the pie down here like this, like that. That was this little edge of the pie, okay? So you can see how we've got the plate in. We've got the shadow in on the plate. We need some light highlights on this. So one of the things, somebody asked me why I like Australian sienna, because when you add white to that, you get this soft yellow color. But again, you can just add a little bit of white to this other stuff. I'll show you that too. And I want a little bit lighter on the pie crust, like that. Right, like that, just a little bit, okay? Leave some of that other color showing. Put a little bit of that color here. And I want right up on top here, I want a little bit of this color with a little bit of burnt sienna right here. There's like this little kind of crusty stuff that happens with your pie. You know, where it kind of, where it toasts and gets to all toasty. I'm putting a little of that there, because right now you're just seeing white. So now we're going to have to shade all this to get this to work. And let's take a little bit of burnt sienna and make a little bit of a darker shadow right here. Make sure we're on our plate. Okay. So let's see. I think we could lighten the plate slightly right here. And I'm just adding a little white to this. I want you to see the difference. And then we'll darken it up right here. Just melt those two together. Okay. Remember, you don't want lines. You want this all to kind of blend in and fade out. Okay. Now, our plate has a white rim on it. And I'm using just an angle brush. This is a ruby satin silver angle. Let's see. What number is this? I think this is quarter inch. See, here's this one. Have I worn the numbers off of this? No, half inch. This is a half inch. All right, so I'm going to come along here using my knife blade and come out here like this. The orange is dry. Now, you just put paint on one side of the brush, okay? You want to zoom in, John? You just put paint on one side of the brush. And then I'm pulling this toward me. And I'm pulling from my shoulder, all right? Do you see that? I'm pulling from my shoulder, okay? And when I run out of paint, I stop. Maybe I'll come this way. Pulling from my shoulder, holding my arm still. Just almost leaning. Okay, and now the middle section in here like this. Okay, so there's the right white rim around the plate. If I need to adjust it, I can. And I'm kind of looking in the mirror saying, do I need to adjust it? This feels like I cut it off a little bit here too much. I'm just going to come out like that a little bit. Kind of fix the curve on it. There we go. Okay. So let's see. In this one, did I need to fix the curve? Do I have a flat tire? I don't want any flat tires, right? I'm going to come out here like this and kind of round it off like this. There we go. There's my white rim. All right. Around the plate. And then I'll come back with a little bit of burnt umber and ultramarine blue, just a tiny bit, kind of darken the shadow right here a little bit. Not too much, but just a little bit. And darken this right here. And I want to say that the pie crust came down over the lip. So what I have to do is I have to shorten this right here. I want to say that the pie crust came down over the lip of the plate like that. Okay? There we go, like that.
Suzanne, I want to let you know that this is a real homemade lemon meringue pie that you're painting. It's not one of the store-bought ones.
You can tell that, right?
Yep, apparently so.
Well, that's good to know, because I wouldn't know, because I don't, you know, really eat those, but I bet I would if I, I don't think anybody ever made pie. You know, nobody ever made a pie in my house growing up.
No, we didn't have pies either. We had cake.
We had blackberry pie, because apparently somebody knew how to make those. And it sure wasn't my mother. My mother didn't bake at all. She went to the store and bought stuff, but she didn't bake anything.
Anne would like to know, what is the reason for the underpainting?
Well, the reason is that you have to cover the canvas with something.
And well, it's already covered in gesso.
It helps your paint stick, right? It helps your paint stick, and it gives you a layer. There's all kinds of reasons for an underpainting. It gives you the layers of color that you're going to need to finish it. There's usually more than one layer of paint. I think that's what people don't appreciate, that there's usually a lot more than one layer of paint. Like, for instance, now I'm going to just sort of skinny up my rim here a little bit now.
Okay, you make like that look so effortlessly.
So see, but this is my second layer of paint. People never use enough paint. That's what I would tell you. And there's a little mixing white, and I want it a little bit lighter over here, see?
I think that's
not
what my
too
problem
much.
Is.
And then just, see, I'll wipe the brush off and then just bring that over this way. There we go, just lightening up a little bit. Okay, so you see, you never want quite just one layer. And here's a little bit of white. I'm going to come along here like this. It's still, now look, this is just white paint. I'll bring it along this edge like this and then just pull it toward me. This is kind of not any different than blending, say, bananas or anything else that we're blending. I mean, that's pretty simple. We're just saying that that's, we're coming along here like this and saying that that's a blended, you know, this part of the plate is a little bit lighter here on the top. Just even more white here because it's still wet. And acrylics dry darker too, which is very misleading. All right. So, all right. So we've got something going on there. Now we're going to make a gray. While this is drying, we're going to make a gray and then we'll hit this with another coat of color, the orange background. But we got something going on there for now. So did you got that question? Let's do one more trivia question. I don't like two. We're going to do it again. I want a different number. Three.
What are we doing? Cheating over there?
Yeah, I want three.
Did you do that as a kid? I bet you did that as a kid. Oh, I don't want that number. That's not going to put me in a good position.
Yeah, you know what else I used to do as a kid? You know, ever had those box of chocolates where you never knew what they were?
You mix them all up?
No, I would just poke my finger underneath until I found one I liked. Until I'd been in the chocolates, right? All right. I want to make a gray color. We're gonna use white and red medium. And a little bit of ultramarine blue. That's our gray color. That's how we make snow and everything. Okay, ready for that? Okay. A little bit. Yeah. Go ahead and ask your question.
Jules wanted to know, I can't get the turquoise color for the plate. What was the mix you used again?
The color is phthalo blue, white, and yellow oxide. Okay.
Phthalo blue, white, and yellow oxide.
Uh-huh.
Sue Clark got it. Nice going, Sue.
And this is the, let's put a little more white with this. This is our gray mixture, which was cad red medium, yellow, ultramarine blue, and yellow oxide. Mostly, or not yellow oxide, ultramarine blue, cad red medium, and white. And mostly it's going to be white with these other colors. And I've got this gray color here that's just part of our pie. This is the shadow side of our pie. And like that. I think probably what we'll do is just sort of cover this part with it, and then we'll put some white over it. But there's a little bit of this color up here. There's a little bit of this little shadow color in here like this, like that, and there's a little bit here. It's our gray color, and I'm going to bring it all the way down here. Just leave a little tiny bit of a light edge the very bottom here, which we'll bring white back to. Now, there's different colors of shadow, there's different darkness, different values in gray, all right? So there's a very dark gray, yeah? So if I needed to darken that gray, I wouldn't even begin to try to do that puddle. I'd just come over here and grab some of it and come over here and start a new place. I wouldn't try to lighten all that up because that's too dark, but I want to come along here like this and in a couple of places on the top of the pie where it's a bit darker, I'm going to add a little bit of this gray color.
Oh, you rolled a three. Thanks for reminding me.
Okay, I rolled a three. Did anybody else? You guys saw that, right?
Yeah, you rolled a three.
Okay.
I got sidetracked when you
okay,
were...
Okay, so I want a little bit of a shadow over here. It's a little bit more on the purpley side. Okay, there's a lots of fun little colors in this pie, all right? Lots
okay,
of fun
these
colors.
Are when, which is a... This is a strange question, but...
When? This is a when?
The when. How much time was needed to build... Trevi fountain in Rome.
The Trevi fountain in Rome?
Trevi fountain in Rome. 3 weeks, 2 years, or 30 years? That's a simple question, people. Everybody knows that one.
Well, I mean, have you ever seen that fountain? It's got all those horses and people and stuff. It's while they're looking, can I tell you a great story about that fountain?
Yeah, absolutely. Let's have a little history on that fountain.
All right,
yeah.
So... I've actually been there, and back when I was 14 years old, and I threw money in that fountain.
How much money did you throw in?
Oh, I don't know, some coins and stuff, and you make wishes, right?
Yeah.
And I wished for you. It just took a long time for you to show up.
I was busy, sorry.
I'm sorry,
I didn't
right?
get the
just
memo.
Went, and where were you, right? Well, you were, never mind, but 14, I know, you know. But anyway, there was this guy that every night would come take all the coins out of the fountain every night. He'd been doing that since the war. And they didn't figure out till about 5 years ago that he'd been doing that just on his own. The city thought he had permission. Nobody questioned it. He'd just been making a living off that fountain since the war, just going in there at night, just cleaning out all the money.
I like that. Most of the consensus is 30 years. What do you say, Ginger?
I think it has to be 30. You sure couldn't have done that in a week.
Nope, 30 years is the correct answer. Yay!
Yay, us! I mean, we haven't stumped
the crowd yet.
We haven't stumped the crowd yet. Well, we're artists here, man. We're a smart group. Now, you notice I've got a little white on my brush, and where these light spots are, I'm adding some just pure titanium white here, making sure I have that, a little bit of white coming up here like that. Here's the white part of my pie. And then I'll just come in here in a few places in the crust, I mean in this gray stuff, and add just a few little crisscrosses of the lighter color so it's not all the same, okay? You can kind of see that. This is fun. This is titanium. I'm not using, bring a little of this stuff back here on the crust. This is a fun painting. I mean, it's not that hard to do, right? So while we're drying that, let's see, I want a little bit of this yellow color. Like
and
this.
And the yellow color is what? Oxide
is
and white?
Well, look, let's take a little yellow oxide, a little white, and a little burnt sienna, okay?
There we go.
And a little bit of yellow. And let's try a little bit of cad yellow medium, a little white.
This kind of the burn part, right?
Yeah, this little burn crusty part.
Yeah.
And let's just lighten this little spot up right here, okay? And the same thing here. And let's make a little darker shadow right this part right there, a little bit of darker shadow here. And let's put a little darker spot right in this part, okay, like that. Just there in a couple of places. And then I want to take some yellow and just cad yellow medium and just make this a little more yellow right here. You know what I mean? How yellow only paints over white like that. Just brighten that up a little bit right there in the front, this yellow. In the photograph, it was pretty pale, but I like the bright yellow color. It's just, we're going to do it. Now, this is why you do two coats of paint. You see the difference between this background and this one. See, this is still too plain. So we need to come back with some more yellow and cad red and do a second coat. Red is some of those colors, you know, and orange and reds really need two coats of paint. It's very nice. If you give it a second coat, it just looks a little more painterly than if you just leave it the one. This is why we're just doing it again. And I don't even mind mixing a little bit on the canvas here like that. Just adding a little bit more color here. And you see where I kind of missed some spots right here. And I'd probably at this point paint the sides. I always like the edges slightly darker. So I'm going to take a little tiny bit of Dosny purple, just a drop of that up here in this corner, and darken this up here. Dosny purple and cad red medium make this kind of dark color next to this crust. I'm going to kind of darken this up here a little bit. That's corner. So this is all part of the painterly process here. And we know we've got this shadow here, so I'm pretty happy with that. But I wanted to make sure that we had enough yellow and then maybe even take a little white, okay? And now look what happens here. I've got a little white with this, and it's almost a tangerine color. And kind of maybe lighten it up around here a bit. See? So you think you can just paint something in, but it always looks better if you give it a few layers. I don't know what that is, particularly in the reds. Give something a few layers. We want a little bit of this. I need a little bit of this orange color right back in here like that on the
Judy,
crust.
Judy has a thought or a question. Okay. Could you use just the leftover paint when you're done that's on your palette to make a blucky gray, an underpainting, a canvas with that?
Yep. Yeah, it's a good idea. You certainly could.
Blucky. It has to be blucky, though.
Well, you
not
could.
Ducky.
You absolutely could, you know. Hey, listen, John, we've had some fantastic people. I'm going to paint the sides on this real quick while I'm waiting for that part to dry. To show you, just paint the sides like this with your leftover paint. John, show some pictures that people have done, if you wouldn't mind.
Oh, here, let me bring one up for you, Ginger.
Yeah, show some pictures. Yeah, I thought that was funny about the Trivoli Fountain. This guy's just helping himself to the money
great.
For all those years. And, you know, what are they going to do? He didn't do anything illegal, exactly.
Well, here's one you're going to enjoy. This is from Honoree.
Oh, yeah, I love this painting. Now, you guys, show. That's her final.
I don't have another one.
Yes, I did. I sent you the
Not
final.
Not in my email.
Yes, I did. I sent you. It's in your email. That's the final. Her first picture, this is one of our...
No, it isn't.
It is.
I'm looking in my email. It's not here.
I sent it to you.
When? After this one?
Yeah, or sometime. Or before this one. This is her final. But the critique was that she had a small child on this painting, and I told her to make the skirt longer and to put some leaves in the puddle. And add a few more leaves. And look what a difference. I wish you could see the difference before and after.
Yeah, I really wish you could, too.
Yeah, man, I sent this to you. All this stuff this morning. You said you had it all, man.
No, man.
Man.
What are you, a hippie man? What are you, back in the 60s, man?
That's
come on,
right.
Man.
Hey, man, I sent this all to you, right? I sent this to you. I remember. I'm not having a senior moment. I sent this to you this morning. With her stuff because I thought it was so impressive. Our original lesson just has to swing. It's a little longer. It's not as high as she made it. But she put this charming girl in there, and just by making the dress longer, it really made a difference on how the painting worked. And putting a few leaves on the water made the little puddle seem, more believable because the leaves are floating on the puddle. Anyway, I thought she did a great job on that. You guys will just have to imagine what it looked like
I'm
before.
Trying to get there. I had to go back to the original art.
Okay.
Well, here, let you look at another one while I try to bring that one in.
Okay, he's going back to the original art. Okay.
Are you still painting your edges?
Yeah, I'm good. Yeah, go ahead. I painted the edge, and that's fine. I'll paint one more edge while you're showing another one. We do the personal art coaching on GingerCookLive.gallery. It's one of the perks of being a member. And
I suppose I had more to go with this one, too.
Actually, no, except there's a final.
She did the final. She did a finished product.
She did a finished one. There's a finished one, and this one I told her to.
Who is this? This is Sissy, isn't it?
This is Sissy's, and I told her to go ahead. You see that, and to put the shadow on the left hand of light, and to go ahead and put a shadow on the back windows, a blue shadow, slight blue shadow on the windows. Okay. Kind of glaze over those windows. Told her to do that.
So
okay.
Sissy gave us a final.
She did. She has a final.
Okay, yeah. You and I need to have a discussion.
You know, maybe you could put these in a folder before we start or something.
They are in a folder, and I go by the emails that you send me.
Well, no. I do.
And I know if I go look at your... No, let's talk about people's email. You know, when you have your email and it comes up and says how many unread messages you have?
Who?
Ginger has 2,423 unread messages in all her emails. And she's asking me, do you have my email? 2,428 unread
Wait,
messages.
Wait, are you on my computer now trying
no.
to find these things?
I should.
You could go under sent mail. You'd see it. Then I'd feel very vindicated. All right.
I should do that, but
All right,
no.
But anyway, so she made a correction on that. You're not finding the corrections?
Well, I've got Honoree's First one.
Oh, here's Honoree's first one now. Okay, that's good, because I want you guys to see, sometimes it's just small stuff. Now, I think Honoree had this super idea when she put that person in the swing. Our lesson didn't have the person in the swing at all. But then, you know, even then, okay, you have an idea to put a person in the swing, what should you do, right? And that's what I told her to do, and that's when she did it. And I thought that final was really cute. And those of you who have done swings may want to go back and put a person in them now that you've been all inspired by her. Huh? John's still struggling along?
Well, I have to open it because it's sideways, but it's not sideways, you know.
When we get me back, and then you can open all your outfitting, and then you can switch.
Where are you?
Just try to put me back a little bit, and then we'll keep going here. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I'm almost done here with this.
Done. She's almost done with the whole painting. Sorry, you missed it all.
I just painted the sides. See, like this. I went ahead and painted the sides. All right, because that's a good thing. I didn't put the top one, but it still needs to be painted. Now I notice that I need a little bit wider out here, so I'm gonna take a little yellow and white, okay? And I need to bring the pie crust out a little bit more this way. Just out in here, need a little bit wider on the edge, and then I'll put a little brown with that, kind of a little tiny bit of burnt sienna with that. Few little, you know, little bits of shadow color, okay?
So I need to find...
And then I want a little bit of the blue shadow color. Well, I guess I don't want that green. But I think we're pretty good. I would say you kind of have an idea of how we're doing this now. You want a little white edge, by the way, when you're talking about edges. You want to make sure you have a little light edge on the very bottom of this, and it kind of swoops up like this and then gets very bumpy up this way. And if you guys like this, you like these food paintings, we have on our website, which I think is really cool, we have on our website, here's our chocolate-covered strawberries. We show you how to do that one. Is that cool? And we've got this piece of cake, you know, this cake one. So you could do a whole series. You could make them a little bigger. These are 8x10. I would recommend doing these larger. This was one that's not dessert, but I love this. It's another one of our lessons on gingercooklive.gallery. I love the pepper. And of course, you've seen the bananas, right? You've seen the bananas that we've got. So we've got a bunch of these food paintings, and I like the dessert ones a lot. Okay, I really do think that the dessert ones are really cool. Okay, so here's a little bit more of the brown crusty stuff going right here.
All right, I think I'm there. Let me check.
John's gonna. He thinks he's found some stuff. Yay, that's good, John. A little more of the gray color up here on the top, just in a couple places. Just to touch it up here like this. And then down in here, a little bit lower down here, a little darker down here.
Oh, just in case you wanted to know, Frisky Christy wants you to know that yes, you can put paint back in the tube if you have one of those disposable syringes. You suck it up and squirt it back in.
Oh, well, that's interesting. I've never seen that done. We'll have to try
that,
John.
I would go with
what
Judy says. Make a bunch of canvases. They all got to be underpainted anyways.
Yeah, well, the thing is, if it gets too old, if it sat out for too long and dried too much, it's really not worth putting back in because it won't behave as nicely. Just by the way, that's the other thing.
Tanya would like to know. I'm coming back to the questions that it's off reading. Could you explain the difference between the Matisse structure and the Matisse flow paint? Are they interchangeable?
The Matisse structure and the Matisse structure are by the same company, and one is the flow paint is a very similar to the golden fluids. I prefer the golden fluids. One, that we're not getting the flows anymore in this country. Jerry's isn't carrying the flows anymore. And the problem I had with the Matisse flows, and this was it, was that you had to shake the tubes, and then some tubes, the paint barely came out, and the other tubes, if you had to be careful, almost had to open the cap vertically on the paint tube, because if you opened it up, half the tube would pour out. I never knew the consistency of it. It never really flowed right for me. I like Matisse, but from the time they made it here, it's a little different experience for those of you guys that live in Australia, but by the time they made it here, then Jerry sold them to us or whatever. But if you buy these golden fluid colors, you know, they're in a jar, you shake them, and you pour them out, and they're lovely every time you use them, okay? That's what I would tell you about these. Okay, so I'm going to do a little bit darker. Now this is my second layer here. Like I say, a little bit purple, a little bit darker under here, under our plate right here, like that. A little bit darker, like that. Just to give it, and then just sort of fuzz that out. Just soften that edge out, almost like pastel, and just soften that edge out. Let's bring it all the way up here like this. I think we did pretty good. Do we want a little bit of that dark color right maybe at the bottom of our pie in a couple places? And make sure we have it dark here. And then under here like this. And then maybe up here at the tip. Let's take a little bit of purple right here like this now. And I want to make sure that this edge right here, there's a shadow right here on the plate like that. I'm going to just make sure that shadow's in. Like that. There you go. That's pretty good. Then I'll take some water. Did you hear the water going? My brush.
Kinda, I thought it was a waterfall.
That's, yeah, I know. And there you go. Now I'm just taking a little water on that and just softening that right out. Maybe even taking a little of the turquoise color and just softening that out. So I want a dark shadow there, but I want to sort of soften it out as it comes out into the plate like that. So there's our shadow color. I want to make sure we have a shadow color back here.
We could call this the Blue Plate Special. Too. Agnes came up with that.
What's that?
The Blue Plate Special.
Blue Plate Special. Oh, that's cute. I think that's wonderful. Now, here's a little more mixing white. Let's lighten up this edge of the plate right here. Okay, just come along here like that and just dry brush that out. There you go. Just lighten this edge up right here like this. And then just the mixing white, it can do that. It allows you to see the blue underneath. And then maybe just a little bit over here like that. Have a little bit lighter right there, darker next to your pie, like that. I'd say we could sign it. I think that's pretty cute. Let me just put them both side by side so you can decide which, you know, if you want to add any more color to this. And you kind of see it. I think I could add a little. When I put them side by side like this, I see where I could add a little bit of a shadow color right here. In here like that, maybe. A little something darker right here. See, I love to do that. Just put something side by side. Just kind of look at it. There's a little darker right here. Like that. Remember, we're artists. This is supposed to be fun. And we looked up this artist for you guys. What was his name, John? He's still alive. He's in his 90s. And he's really famous for painting food. And we found this out after we painted this.
Thibaud. It's T-H... I-E-B-A-U-D.
Thibaud. Thibaud, right?
They don't do the T-H? No. Why put in letters you're not using?
I don't know. I didn't make this up. And here's a little bit of light yellow here. Like there, kind of a glaze.
Lynn would like to know, how long did your angle brushes last? Not long enough?
Well, they last pretty good. If you're supposed to be able to put them in boiling water and reshape them and get them back. But the ruby satin silvers will last a lot longer than, say, the Simply Simmons, in my opinion. Let me phrase that. They have for me, anyway, right? But I have a couple here that I had to, they're heading for the boiling water bin.
Yeah.
But, I mean, I use these all the time. I mean, you guys, you can see that. I use these all the time. And, you know, which is kind of cool. I'm going to take a little white here. So now, see, I'm seeing stuff here, see? I'm going to come over here now and just plop this down like that, a little bit of white.
Mudgy would like to know, does mixing white get more transparent as it dries?
You know, what you need to do is experiment with it. Depends on what it's going over. You know, not necessarily. Acrylics generally get darker as they dry. I see something I have to do. I forgot this. Sorry. All right, this came up like this with the meringue. Right like that. This came up like that.
Oh, they say it's
this
pronounced
was a sharp
Tebow.
Angle right there. See?
Well, they have way too many letters in there then.
So there was a sharp angle on. See, and I didn't see that. You see before? This is why you look at your picture side by side. But just look at something side by side. Look at it in a mirror. Let's make
stand
it
stand on your head.
Let's You want to? I want to get my turquoise color back again. Here we go. There we go. I got that a little dark, but here's my, okay. That was cad yellow medium, phthalo blue, and white. Okay, that's how we made that turquoise color. Everybody remembers that? That's a pretty color, isn't it? It's very similar to Southern Ocean Blue, isn't it? Don't you guys think so?
I do.
think it's a very similar color. I'm just going to make that a little bit darker next to the white. See, had to do that, and then I'm going to pull some of that color. Since I did that there, then I'm going to pull some of this color right here. You know, as long as I've changed colors a little bit, then you can get away with that if you just remember to put it somewhere else. Okay, so now, oh, that's very pretty next to the orange. Isn't that pretty next to the orange? So there we go. And we need a little more gray color right up in here. So all I have to do is take a little bit of the ultramarine blue and add it. I'm going to show you a different way to make a gray and add it to that turquoise and then add a tiny bit of cad red medium with that. Now I've got this different gray. It's a different gray. You see, that's kind of a green gray. See how I'm making that?
That's a patty color.
Okay, and then I'm going to rinse my brush because I was using it for gray. Then I'm going to come up here like this and just tap that, take a tiny bit of that color and tap that on in here like this up at the top. Give this a little bit more gray up here so I have less white showing than I originally had there like that.
Nicole would like you to make a fruit pie after this one, please.
Okay, there. I'm a little bit happier with that. Now I'm going to come back with the white. And here's my little punk of white paint.
That's a big punk of white paint.
And on top of that, I just needed to, then I can get away with that because it's, there we go. That's it. There we go. A little bit of white, a little bit of the meringue coming out this way at an angle and then down like that. There we go. I think that looks much better. I'm happy with that. Like this, then bring the yellow up here, like this. This yellow comes out this way, and then down. There we go. And there's our pie, and let's put a little white, mixing white with that yellow, like that, so that we give it a little highlight. See, I mean, I can look at this and probably paint, you know, a little bit more, but I think you get the idea. Oh, that's great. I like that. A little bit of white dots back there, and we're done. Yay! Awesome, right?
You did in record time, 1 hour, 10 minutes. Well, 1 hour, 11 minutes. Look at there.
I think that's kind of cool, right? That's kind of cool. And
two pieces of pie.
Yeah, and you know, remember, we've got all these. If you like, we've got pie. We're going to do more cakes and stuff like that. And then remember, you guys remember this lesson? Isn't this, remember this one?
I do.
Our apples? That's on our website right now, right? I don't think that's up on YouTube. That's on that's on our website, right?
Yeah.
And then this was last week's fruit painting on our website, and I can't believe the great job everybody's doing on that. If you want to see what some of your friends are doing on this group, go to my Pinterest page, 2017 Student Board, check out. Your painting might be up there and you don't even know it. And Sylvia, my good friend in Australia, I promised I'd put your painting up there, the mask. Sylvia did this killer mask. We'll show it to you tomorrow. And I haven't got it up there yet, but I am doing it. And this is coming up, probably not this week, but the week after we're doing this one then.
That's coming soon.
That's coming soon. That's one of our firm members, okay? So, you see, we're all about food and clouds and all kinds of stuff. So kind of exciting. And the palette's really pretty, isn't it? Look at this beautiful orange and this turquoise and stuff. Now, this is interesting. We broke some rules here. Would you guys like to know what they are?
I'd like to thank Joanne first for donating $5 for a piece of pie.
Oh, thank you, Joanne. That is so awesome.
Your pie is in the mail.
Really appreciate that very much. Gosh, that's great. One thing that, you know, you may not know, right, is that when you're talking about warm and cool colors, we broke a rule here tonight, and I think it worked anyway, all right?
What did we break?
Well, generally speaking, a painting is going to be warm or it's going to be cool.
This is kind of a combo, isn't it?
And it's a combo, and then you're going to have... You generally don't want 50-50 on the compliments. Generally, as a rule, you don't want that. You want to pick a dominant color and have the compliment, which is orange, be an accent.
Yeah. That's not the case here, is it?
But that's not the case, but it still works, doesn't it? And it works, and it's, you know, because it's a different type of, you know, setting, right, like this. I need a little bit more light right here on the plate. There you go. Just
remember the other day you were talking about adding words to a painting?
Oh yeah, I told somebody that I would show them how to do it.
Kathy.
And the Kathy, I'm going to check. Kathy wanted to know how you would get some words on a picture, right? So just give me do you have a piece of, you know, all right, grab me this fine line acrylic painting right there, that sign. All right, Kathy, this is how you do it. I said I'd show you how to do it. And all right, now you found some nifty script on the computer. You even bought some fonts, right? And you want to add those to a painting. Maybe you want to put up here in the corner, cake by Susie or something, right? Okay. I don't know who Susie is. I'm just saying, maybe Susie wants to do that, right?
Okay.
So you type it out on a piece of paper the size that you want it, right? On regular typing paper, on a regular inkjet printer, nothing too fancy, you know, not one of the other fancy printers, just the cheapo printer that everybody's got, okay? You with me? Okay, then you take, do we have that?
What?
Gloss, medium, and varnish, that stuff right there. The gloss, medium, and varnish. All right, so this, see this, suppose I wanted this word outline, online, Academy of Fine Art. So then I would take this gloss, medium, and varnish, and I would set this on a wax paper palette, so I didn't glue it down. Maybe I'd cut this word out around it like this, right? Just sort of cut out the word about like that, maybe in a circle. Cut out that word, or whatever word I wanted. Cut it out so I'm not using a lot of varnish. And then I would give it a coat of this varnish. And every couple hours, I'd give this a coat of varnish, and over a few days, I'd have about 10 coats of this varnish, drying it in between on this word, okay? I'm saying I want that word, okay, on my painting. So then what's going to happen is, and this is really interesting, what's going to happen is that you're going to then take the paper into the bathroom, into warm water, or in a bowl or something with warm water, and you're going to soak off the paper. And what's going to be left is a clear piece of acrylic, because that's what this stuff does, dry clear. And you can't use matte because it's cloudy, so sorry, no, the answer is no. It has to be gloss, medium, and varnish. And you have that, and then the paper's gone. So then you use this like a glue, figure out where you want it, and then you'd have to varnish your whole piece, so it would kind of, you know, and then you'd go ahead and put that down and varnish over it, and it would look like you painted it on. So it's kind of an old decoupage. You could do this with musical notes. You could do this with, I've seen people do this with magazines, but the magazine paper doesn't dissolve very well. It's always better if you have something you want to put on there like that to, you know, have some real cheap paper that's going to dissolve in water. And then all that's left is the acrylic, and that's how you get the word on. That's cool, right? And I thought, you know, I was going to try and have an example of it. Maybe next week I can show you exactly how to do it. I'll do it myself and show you.
There's a warning going out that not all brushes can be boiled. This is for the particular brand that Simply Simmons.
Simmons. The lady at Simply Simmons, that woman that owned it, said that's what you do with her brushes, but I don't think you leave them in boiling water. I think you just dip them in there. There were no real instructions with them that I could tell, but you don't, a lot of your brushes would just fall apart if you did that. But apparently hers, the silver line of brushes is such an outstanding line of brushes. And they're made, you know, the fibers come from Japan. They are extraordinary fibers, and they're really an amazing brush. This is not the most expensive line that they make, though this is the best in the short angles. The next line up from there, the next one up, and I've been using Simply Simmons for years, the next line up from that is the Bristolon. That's the Bristolon brushes. Is that this one?
Glasses on top of your
no,
head.
No, that's the silver. It's the no, one this one here. Yeah. This is the Bristolon, and they make bright brushes and ones like this, and that's the next grade up from the Ruby Satin Silvers. I've been using Ruby Satin Silvers for years. Our art store never carried anything like this. These are a little more expensive, but I've been using for 30 years. I've been using the silver brushes, and I just love that line. They don't pay me to say this. I don't have a brush deal like Cinnamon. Nobody's got giving me anything. I just will tell you my honest opinion. And you'll get it, you know what I mean? Like you asked me what I thought about the flow paint from Matisse. I mean, they're not paying me either. I'm just saying, in my experience, Jerry's doesn't carry it anymore. And B, Golden still carries their flows, and they all flow the same, you know? Their fluid acrylics are all, and they come in a little tiny bottle too. You don't have to buy a big one. And when would you want these? You'd want these for like signing your name or doing tiny little leaves. I'd have white and dark brown in a flow.
I would go with the white. You can at least tint it if you wanted something else, right?
You could always tint the white, but I would at least have a dark brown.
Oh, that came up. What's the difference between tinting and glazing? We're thinking there is an actual difference.
I don't know that there is that much of a difference. Glazing, you can tint a color. You can take white and tint it. But glazing is where you take an actual glazing fluid and put a tiny bit of color in it, and it's like a tea stain. And it can only go, you can glaze over something darker. But I mean, it's over. You can glaze over something lighter than what you're glazing over, but you can't glaze if you're using white.
Now, going back,
so if you're using white, you're probably tinting, and if you're using there you go. If you're using white, you're tinting, and if you're using glazing medium, there's no white in it. It's just the glazing fluid. Like here's a golden glazing medium, and you would just use that and a tiny bit of the color. You can go up to 50%, I think, color on that. They have directions. You should read them. Don't you love? Everybody knows. Not everybody knows this, but I mean, how many people can read that really? You know, I had surgery and I don't even need to wear glasses, technically, you know, except for reading glasses. And I'm thinking, can I read that? Well, I kind of can read that. Use alone or blend with acrylic colors in any ratio. Any ratio, interesting. Any ratio. That means you can use it all by itself or any ratio of color. So the reason you want a tinting is that, you know, like for instance, suppose I wanted to tint this a little bit darker here. Let's just experiment with that. Do we have a little cup? Yeah, here. All right, this is good. I'm happy to show you this stuff. Suppose we wanted to tint a little something right here like that. So here's a little bit of the color. And suppose I wanted to tint this a little darker than this, right? Just suppose. Oh, I know. What if I wanted to tint the white rim on this plate?
Ooh, you wild and crazy girl.
Well, what would I tint it? So maybe I wanted it to have a purple cast. Okay? So here's some Dasani purple. And I'll put a little tiny bit in there. I don't want very much, right? So I've got a little tiny bit in there. Just a tiny spot of Dasani purple.
Can you hold it under the camera?
Like that. There's hardly any, right? Like that.
Well, it's really thick stuff.
Yeah, it's thick. And then I'm going to come around here like this, and I'm going to go over this white. And you're barely going to see it, okay? You're barely going to see it. It's going to have the slight. Tell you, I couldn't mix the purple to get it like that. It almost looks like stained glass. Here's a little bit. See the purple? Little tiny bit of purple. Or maybe I want a little bit of purple on some.
Oh, now she's going crazy.
Now I want a little bit, maybe a little bit of purple on some of this white here, just in a couple places. But I want still the white to show in something else, so you barely see it, right? Or maybe I want this to have a little bit of a purple cast to it, but not much, right? Now look what that does. See, I want a little bit of a purple cast to here. So, I mean, you use very little of the color, but you could use more of the color. Here, I'll put more of the color in. You could use more of the color if you wanted, but that changes what it does. You see that? So that you see the purple? That's kind of pretty, isn't it? Come on, you guys, because this is the shadow side of the plate. That's kind of purple, right? That's pretty, right?
It's very pretty.
See? I mean, I'm just saying. You're saying, what can you do with that? And this is, I think I kind of like the purple. I'm just saying, right? Like that. See, I kind of like the purple on the plate. Or maybe I want a little purple right here, and I could glaze over this, and you let it dry in between, and then you get layers of colors in your picture that you normally wouldn't get. See? Like that. Yeah, put a little purple there, or maybe I've got a little bit right there over some of this white. Kind of neat, right? But it only really works over something. It wouldn't do me anything to do it over something dark, but it'll do pretty well over anything slightly lighter than it, right? Like that. Like it'll glaze over this yellow and change it dramatically, right? Or maybe cause a little shadow right here, just glazing over the yellow. So you ought to just play with that a little bit with your leftover paint. Make yourself some strips of color, get some glazing medium, and dry the strips and see what it does, so that next time you're painting something, you know exactly what it is that you want it to do. And I see something I want it to do here. I want to come up here like this and make this more of a point here. So you take a little glazing medium and do that, like that, just like that. I want that more of a point.
Just a reminder to some of the late crowd that's coming in right now, the contest will be drawn tomorrow. The contest is over as far as entries. We have 160 valid answers.
Yep.
And the winner will be getting the proposal painting, an original by Miss Cook herself.
Yeah, this is pretty cool.
And that will be drawn live tomorrow night show. And the auction is ended. Thank you for all that participated there. We'll have another auction in the future. And another question came up with on your decoupaging thing that you're doing, getting the words off. Mm-hmm. Does that work with inkjet or does it have to be laser?
I think you want the cheap inkjet. You don't want the laser.
Well, some people are saying that it smears. The liquid will smear. See, whereas the laser doesn't smear.
Well, then maybe it has to be laser. You can't, if it smears, like for instance, what is this? Is this inkjet or laser?
Yeah, it's inkjet. Put some on it.
All right, come on. That's the challenge. Does it smear or not? We don't know, right? So here's some of that glazing medium. It's the same stuff, right?
You use my... it's right there, the big bottle.
Here we go. All right.
I opened it for you. Just put a little bit out on it.
Okay, so let me get another cup. We got another cup over here. Here's another little cup. All right, so we're going to try it, right? This is the... What is this? Okay, we're going to try it right now, okay?
That's enough,
right? There you go. All right, now... But that didn't go on there at all. All right, now, here we are. It's not smearing.
Let me zoom in.
Now, that's all I'm going to do with that word, just like that. That's it. I don't keep going over it. I'm stopping. That's it.
As she keeps painting over, I'm stopping.
Well, but that's it. I covered it, right? Now, in an hour...
You're going to do it again.
I can do it again. And then, as you know, you ought to have just a brush and a bag, you know, just have an old brush and, you know, in a plastic Ziploc bag so you don't have to keep washing it, and have some of this stuff, and every once in a while, you just cover it, okay?
Now, this is an HP inkjet, the one that we've been telling people about where you get the ink for $5 a month.
Oh, yeah, and you print out all these colored pictures. It's so fantastic. So fabulous. I just, anytime I want to print something out, I'm just printing out.
That doesn't look like it smeared to me.
No, it didn't smear.
So.
Okay. So, I mean, that's how you do it, right, like that, you know.
So, we'll paint that some more. We'll see what happens.
You know, we just, there it goes. And so, let's put our picture back. All right, here's our painting back. I think we're ready to sign it. And this is where, you guys, you would use the fluid paint, you know. This is where you'd use the fluid paint for signatures. It's so much better than just, or you could use, people say, what do you like? I like the white Sharpie oil painting pen fine point. My problem with it is that it clogs up a lot. Actually, it's good for the first time, and then after that, it's anybody's guess.
Yeah, you get one or two times out, and that's it.
And so here it is. Now look at the beautiful signature I can get using a tiny brush. This is one of Cinnamon's brushes, by the way. This is a silver little pointy brush like that. I mean, that's great, isn't it? And then I always put the red slash through my name, like that.
Always.
There, like that. There you go. So, I mean, you can do it. I love that color, don't you? Let's do a little dash of color somewhere here. Sorry. Okay.
Never done.
All right. So, that's our lemon meringue pie.
That's our blue plate special.
Our blue plate
special.
Blue plate. Is that the blue plate special? Is that what we said it was? Yeah.
Yeah. Lemon meringue pie.
Then here in this picture, you can see it.
Don't put them up.
You know?
Because your picture's up there in the corner.
There. So. So can you just leave them like that? What?
Just leave them alone!
Fine. I'm leaving them alone. I'm leaving.
I move that camera. I keep moving and you keep moving it.
Okay. So there we go. You can kind of see it. I love all the colors in here. And the reason we love the colors is because we're talking about complementary colors again, right?
Yes, we are.
And orange is opposite turquoise on the color wheel. And it's stunning when you put them together. So great. I think I hope everybody had fun tonight. We're going to have a blast with the, you know, getting the winners tomorrow night. We want to thank everybody. Again, if you were in the auction, the high bidders will be getting an email this week with a thank you letter and an invoice and then we'll need an address about where to send it when you send in your payment.
All right, everybody, thank you. We have a few more questions coming in. I can answer them very quickly. What does the red slash mean? Go look at all the videos. It's out there somewhere.
Oh, this is kind of mean. I'll tell you.
Well, you don't bother. We're bad streaming right now.
We're bad streaming. Next tomorrow night, we'll talk about it.
Talk about that tomorrow night. Have you tried Cinnamon's brushes yet? Not fully, because
yeah, this
they
haven't been released. Yeah, I bought a bunch of them.
But not the official Cinnamon ones yet,
yeah,
though.
Cinnamon's official. These are the ones that she's using on her website that she's recommending now from the Filver Company, right? And on the brush guys, all right? So I went on there, and I bought about $60 worth of brushes. I mean, you know. Just to try them. I wanted to see. And I like that. I had never tried these Brislon brushes. I like those. She just has this particular one. Her official set, she's still doing. She's getting apparently something called the... She's getting an official set of brushes out, and they're still working on that. But she's got... They're all... You know, these are all brushes on Cinnamon's website she's picked out. They're all good. I like all her brushes. They're fine. My personal preference has always been, and I'm just, you know, we all get that way, right? Like some people like Chevys and some people like Fords. I love the Silver Brush Company. I always have loved them. And I I love these ruby satin silver brushes, and I will probably, as time goes on, buy a set of the brights in the Brislon, because that's the next one up from that. And they don't make a small short handled angle except for these. And my, you saw I painted this whole painting with this half inch angle brush. I love these angle brushes. These, and they're so great. So I mean, I just absolutely love those. Got to buy some more. I love them.
The printer we're using is that HP printer, and it's called Ink.
Well, we have a we do not have a link on our website to the printer.
We had a link in one of the YouTube somewhere.
Well, we had it on the YouTube, but I thought we had it on our website too.
It could
be
on our website.
John can't remember. You know, it's HP. When I first got my printer a couple years ago, they offered, the HP's got about five printers on Amazon where they offered this ink deal by the month, and it is, they were not counting on artists using it. That's what's so funny. They were thinking it was some, it's not such a great deal if you're just printing black and white. I mean, it's okay, but it's not great. But if you're like me, they don't differentiate between the color. They know everything you print because you hook up to the internet with that. When you start to run out, you don't even have to order ink. They send it to you ahead of time. But if you panic, they'll send you more. I panicked one time. They sent me more ink immediately. They didn't want to be the least bit upset. And they were not counting on artists using those printers. Oh no, they were not thinking that we were going to do it. But you know, it's not a deal from them for us artists, because we can print out, you can just happily print out all the color stuff you want, and it's the most that can cost you is whatever they want for, like, it was $5 a month, what, 100 pages, something like that.
Yeah.
And then if you go over, it was next to nothing. It was a great deal. And John's got one of the printers. I have a printer. We use them all the time.
Wouldn't be without them.
No,
those work
great. Great printer, and you saw the ink didn't smear.
And we'd like to thank the moderators once again for hanging in there with us. Appreciate you, Kim Sim,
thank you.
And Miss Wendy.
Miss Wendy, it's not Sing Song, it's Kim Sim, right?
You're a character. Well, everybody, thank you for another lovely evening. We had a high of 305 people visit us tonight and 231 thumbs up.
Oh, thanks, you guys. And don't
forget,
if you haven't subscribed, tell your friends and share. And keep these, if you put these videos in a playlist, you know, if you put them in a playlist, YouTube, that helps YouTube think that you like them, and they start sharing them more. Did you know that?
Even if you don't like them, add us to your playlist.
Yeah, start throwing these videos in your playlist, right?
Thanks, everyone. Good night, and we'll see you tomorrow. Good night, Ginger.
Night, John. Night, Sammy.
Well, yeah, as if Sammy's awake.